Hello there, welcome to the Football Bloc. My name is Brandon, and today we're going to look ahead to Manchester City versus Liverpool. And I'm going to give you my predictions. I'm going to tell you how I think the match is going to end up. If that sounds interesting, then let's hop right into it.
Eu quis amar, mas tive medo e quis salvar.
So we have the biggest game, or at least the biggest league game in Europe this weekend with Manchester City versus Liverpool. Now, realistically, whoever wins this match will go on to win the Premier League title, in my opinion at least. If you look at the league table here, Manchester City is top of the table, but it is a 1-point gap between them and Liverpool, of course, in second place. And both teams, you can make the argument, are the best two teams in Europe right now, just on, you know, looking at games in the past few weeks. They have been storming through the Champions League, storming through the Premier League, and then they're even going to face each other in the semifinals of the FA Cup. Both these teams have been scoring a ton of goals. Both their defenses are really good. Now, you just look top to bottom on these teams. You look at the top for Manchester City. They have guys like Riyad Mahrez, Kevin De Bruyne, Bernardo Silva. And then they are in the back, then they have João Cancelo, John Stones, Ederson's great goal. But then you compare that to Liverpool, Sadio Mane, Mohamed Salah, Luis Diaz, who they just signed, Diogo Jota, as well as the back of Virgil van Dijk, Andy Robinson, Trent Alexander-Arnold, Alisson. So these two teams, like I said, the two best teams in the world at the moment as we speak. And, you know, this match is setting up to be a crazy match. To predict this, in my opinion, is pretty tough because, you know, sometimes you look at this matchup, there's a clear favorite, I would say, or, you know, sometimes even if the team is unfavored, there is a possibility that you say that, okay, this team is definitely, like, they have it in them to win. Both these teams have it in them to win, and there really is no clear favorite. I mean, just look at the Premier League table here. Manchester City have a stronger defense. They've only conceded 18 goals, but then Liverpool have a stronger offense. They've scored 77 goals compared to Manchester City's 70. We're talking hairline margins here. It's not like one of these teams has a much better defense or a much better offense than the other. It's, you know, both these teams are, you know, miles above everyone else. But when it comes to between them, there's like barely anything to separate them. The style of play as well, it's both of these teams have a very unique and distinct style of play. You're talking about Klopp with Liverpool and the gegenpressing, but then also you have, you know, Manchester City with this, you know, Pep's revitalized version of tiki-taka, which is, you know, super possession-based, but then also there's emphasis on defense now. So it'll be really interesting to see how these two teams line up against each other. Now, since both of these teams just came off Champions League quarterfinal, the first leg of the quarterfinals, there might be some fatigue, maybe. Now, of course, you can say, you know, fatigue's not going to play an issue because both these teams are going to be fired up for this game, which is, you know, maybe even more important than Champions League quarterfinal first leg. Now, if you look at their most recent game, Manchester City went up against Atletico Madrid. Atletico stuck in deep. They defended really well. It was hard for Manchester City to break through. But a combination of great play between Phil Foden and Kevin De Bruyne gave Manchester City a 1-0 win. And then Liverpool played Benfica in Benfica, and Liverpool was by far the better team. They crushed Benfica. It ended up being 3-1. It could have been more. But they did give up a pretty easy goal, a mistake by Konate at the back. So I think going into this match, I'm going to say that it is... I'm going to say it's going to be a 1-1 draw, and I'm going to say, so neither team is going to win. The Premier League title will still yet to be decided. I think that Manchester City will take the lead in the second half. The first half is going to be super tense, really close, but Manchester City is going to take the lead in the second half after a goal from Riyad Mahrez, I'm going to say, after great build-up play between him and Phil Foden. But just before the match ends in what's looking like it's going to be a 1-0 victory to Man City, I'm going to say Luis Diaz is going to score a late equalizer for Liverpool. That guy has been in great form, great scoring form for Liverpool ever since he signed in January. So I'm going to say that he scrapes a last minute equalizer that's going to level the score at 1-1. It's going to be a great game. It's going to be, you know, back and forth. I don't think either team is really going to be able to fully dominate the match. I think we're also going to see some good individual performances as well. Maybe both, like, the Brazilian goalkeepers in Alisson and Ederson. Maybe the defenders as well. John Stones going up against, you know, Sadio Mane versus Virgil van Dijk versus, you know, Gabriel Jesus. Something like that. I think it's going to be just, you know, back and forth, really tight. Neither team is really going to get an edge over each other, but it's going to end 1-1. So let me know what your predictions are. Do you think that Man City is going to win? Do you think Liverpool is going to win? Do you also think it's going to be a draw? What do you think the score is going to be? Who do you think is going to score? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to like and subscribe as well. My name is Brandon. This has been the Football Bloc. I hope you guys have a nice rest of your night. Ba-di-la-da-ba-da-ba-di-ba-dum-da, da-yum-da.